ALS is a short form of amyotrophic lateral sclerosis. You might also have heard it called LOU Gehrig disease, after the baseball player who was diagnosed within the 1930s. A French doctor named Jean-Martin Charcot discovered the condition in 1869. ALS is a progressive disease, which means it gets worse over time. It affects nerves in your brain and spinal cord that control your muscles. As your muscles get weaker, it gets harder for you to walk, talk, eat, and breathe. ALS and motor neurons. It's a disease that affects your motor neurons. These nerve cells send messages from your brain to your spinal cord and then to your muscles. You have two main types. Upper motor neurons, nerve cells in the brain. Lower motor neurons, nerve cells in the spinal cord to muscles. These motor neurons control all your voluntary movement, the muscles in your arms, legs and face. They tell you muscles to contract you so you can walk, run, pick up your smartphone, chew and swallow food and even breathe. ALS is one of the few motor neurons disease. Some other include primary lateral sclerosis, PLS, progressive bulbar palsy, PBP, pseudo bulbar palsy. What happens when you have ALS? With ALS, motor neurons in your brain and spinal cord breaks down and die. When this happens, your brain can't send messages to your muscles anymore, because the muscles don't get any signals. They become very weak. This is called atrophy. In time, the muscles no longer work and you lose control over their movement. At first, your muscles get weak or stiff. You may have more trouble with fine movements, such as trying to button a shirt and turn a key. You may stumble or fall more than usual. After a while, you can move your arms, legs, head or body. Eventually, people with ALS lose control of their diaphragm, the muscle in the chest that help you breathe. Then, they can breathe on their own and will need to be on a breathing machine. The loss of breathing causes many people with ALS to die within 3 to 5 years after they are diagnosed. Yet, some people can live more than 10 years with the disease. People with ALS can still think and learn. They have all their senses, sight, smell, hearing, taste and touch. Yet the disease can affect their memory and decision-making ability. ALS isn't curable. Yet, scientists now know more than these diseases can ever be. What are the main types? There are two types of ALS. Sporadic ALS is the most common form. It affects up to 95% of people with the disease. Sporadic means it happens sometimes without a clear cause. Familial ALS falls, runs in families. About 5% to 10% of people with the ALS have this type. Falls is caused by changes to a gene. Parents pass a faulty gene to their children. If one parent has the gene for the ALS, each of the children will have the 50% chances of getting the gene and having the disease. What causes ALS? Researchers still don't know exactly what causes motor neuron to die with the ALS. Gene changes or mutations are behind 5% to 10% of ALS cases. More than 12 different gene changes have been linked to ALS. One change is to a gene that makes a protein called SOD1. This protein may be toxic to motor neurons. Other gene changes in ALS might also damage motor neurons. The environment can also play a role in ALS. Scientists are also studying whether people who come into the contact with certain chemicals or germs are more likely to get the disease. Scientists are also looking to the other possible causes. Glutamate. The chemical sends signals to and from the brain and nerves. It's a type of neurotransmitter. With ALS, glutamate builds up the spaces around the nerve cells and may damage them. The medication Riluzole, Rilotec, works by lowering glutamate levels and can help slow the development of the disease. Immune system problems. Your immune system protects your body from foreign invaders such as bacteria and viruses. In your brain, microglia are the main type of immune cells that destroy germs and damaged cells. With ALS, microglia might also destroy healthy motor neurons. Mitochondria problems. Mitochondria are the parts of your cells where energy is made. A problem with them might lead to ALS or make an existing case worse. Oxidative stress. Your cells use oxygen to make energy. Some of the oxygen your body uses to make energy may form into toxic substances called free radicals, which can damage cells. What they discover will help them develop medication to treat symptoms and improve the lives of people who have this disease. The Cares and Cures team want you and those close to you to live a healthy, happy life. Your health is a valuable thing. Look after your health and your mind so that you can live your life to the fullest. Remember, you only get one. Please share this with your friends and family and do let us know what do you think in the comments below. This video is solely for informational purposes. Do not self-diagnose or self-medicate, and in all cases, consult a certified healthcare professional before using information presented in this video. The editorial board does not guarantee any result and does not bear any responsibility for any harm that may result from using the information presented in this video.